Radhika is the most, who understands? ऐसे ग्रोथ के किसी को दिखाई देता है। राधिका इज स्टॉपमोस्ट एंड सी साथी में बढ़ती का एक किसी को दिखाई देता स्पोक दिस मैं श्री कृष्ण के किंग सिंगल वर्ड एंड फेवरेट हर बाय द पावर्स एंड इट्स रेड सी वर्ड साथी में बढ़ती का स्टॉपमोस्ट नहीं का फुल ऑफ द वर्ड लक्ष्मी देवी आम लिमिटेड लक्ष्मी देवी एंड दैट एट पॉइंट ब्रेड रूपीज दे आर द सी स्टॉप मोस्ट ऑन दी वन राधिका सो हाउ इज राधिका मूविंग हाउ सी मैनिफेस्ट एंड श्री कृष्ण ही इज रसिक शेखर All is destiny. This Radhika is moving. More moved, wonderful, moved, manifest. This result. Our place. Sri Krishna always says, this mood and always he plays with Sri Krishna, our beautiful feet. So, This is called Vrindavan. In Vrindavan, more. Then, Radharani. Some group and people don't know who. Why the people don't know who? After them, they come to Vrindavan. Some group. At that time, Rasaraj and Mahaprabhu. He is Gauri Sundar. He is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Number one Vrindavan. This Vrindavan is number one Radhika's own place. So Seta Devi, Radhika's place. Sri Krishna always testing this mood, Radhika's mood. And Sri Krishna, he is testing Radhika's mood. Radhika is topmost. She is Visha. In Sridharas, Visha is Radharani. Ashray is Sri Krishna. Because Sri Krishna is Upasana. And worshipable Lord is Radharani. Sri Krishna always testing Radhika to move opposite. Every year, all Mangalacharan. All Kapha Sastra, everywhere, Kapha Rasi, devotion. This goal, Sri Krishna is growing. And of our ancestors to Sri Krishna, and we are not saying Radhika is ready. But, when Gita Govinda wrote, Kavi Devi will serve his role. Radha Madhava Yojayanti. Radha Madhava Yojayanti.
Om Namo Shivaya 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 Om Namo Shiv scelto di Dio, ho fatto una temperatura su di mano. Thank you all the successes, it is by Bishop. All the devotees, all the sisters, mothers, friends and guests. We are doing Vrindavan Parikrama. This is not something which was invented by some previous acharya. Actually, Mahaprabhu himself, he did the first Vrindavan Parikrama. He came, and this is the subject that we have been speaking since yesterday evening. He came and he did Parikrama himself. Now, we are Gaudiya Vaishnavas. Means we are following in the mood of worship of Lord Gauranga. How he is doing? He is of Bhajan Sikshaturu, which Gurudev writes in his Manasiksha commentary. We are worshipping Krishna. But how to worship Krishna in the Kali Yuga? We know that when Krishna gave Bhagavad Gita and went back, folded his pastimes back to the spiritual world, he was wondering. In Kali Yuga, people are very lazy spiritually, very unfortunate, Manda Bhavya, always disturbed by something. I have told them to surrender. How they will surrender? Maybe I should go and show them how to do it. So in the words of Srila Gaudiya Maharaj, Sri Krishna, Jagadguru, he is a theoretical teacher. And when he comes as Mahaprabhu, he is a practical teacher. Now we have all heard from the lotus mouths of the various holy speakers that Mahaprabhu is no different from Krishna. Mahaprabhu is not a different entity, another person. He is Krishna himself, but who has some very special desire to understand what is the glory of his most beloved, Srimati Radhika. What is the glory of her love? That is its first thing. She has, her love is unfathomable. But still he wants to try. Now how can a man understand the love of a woman? It's not possible. Different body, different psychological makeup. But is there any desire that God cannot fulfill? Of course he can do anything. So he was thinking, I have to get that experience. And for this, he wanted to get the mood and feelings of Srimati Radhika. Now he knew there are three ways, beg, steal or borrow, right? He knew if I beg or borrow, she will not give. Only one solution is left, to steal. And Krishna is an expert thief from birth, stealing Gopi's love, stealing butter, stealing the gloves, stealing everything, the heart. His very name, Hari, means I am stealing. So for him, no difficulty. How did he steal the mood of Srimati Radhika? He put her in fire of separation. And her heart melted, then he entered her heart, he plundered her heart, took her mood, and went away. And this way, now he had the mood, now he could try to do. But you know, one time, Gopi's dog, Shri Krishna. Oh, thanks God, you're not a girl. Because if you had been a girl, all the kings of the world, they would have fought for your hand, and the whole world would be on fire and blood. Thanks God, you're not a girl. But he wanted to understand the feelings of that particular girl, Radhika. So he did not become a girl, but he took her mood, and also her color. Kanti-jyuti subalitam, Namikrishna sarupam, or bhav and also color. Because in the spiritual world, everything is very personal. Every color and moods are associated. Like it is said, Lord Balaram, he is camphor-like, moon-like, the color of mercy, white, that kind of whitish camphor color. That is the color of mercy. So Balaram, who is Akanda Guru Tattva, mercy personified, the original teacher, his color is white. And the color that the renounced order is wearing, this is Anuradha. Oh, when the desire for Krishna becomes very, very strong, then it takes that color, rising sun, Aruna, so Anurag color. So first he said you should dye your heart that color, then you should wear the color. Srila Śrīla Mahārāja said, die to live, D-I-E, but you should say, die to live, D-Y-D, dye your heart to live in that transcendental world. So first dye your heart that color, then you can dye to the world externally. So first it should be dyed saffron inside. So Śrīmatī Radhika, she gave her mood and color to Krishna. But still, you know that in our dictionary there is only one word, how to please him. She is Ladini Shati, love means to give pleasure. She has only one desire, one function, one mood, how to give him satisfaction in all ways, like we heard from the mouth of Tirtha Maharaj. She only wants to please him. So when she is in Vrindavan, she's always manifesting the opposition mood, Vamyata. We have heard also from the other small of the speakers that, you know, Lalita Devi is always instructing her, oh, don't be submissive. Oh, Kalankini, Radhe, and Chess, why are you giving it so easily? Always play hard to get. Every girl knows this in this world. It's a very, you know, reflection of the original mood of Śrīmatī Radhika. Every girl knows if a boy is coming and showing some interest and very easily she gives in, then the boy will take advantage but no deep appreciation. So every young thing knows if she just looks away, you know, neglectfully, then his interest is aroused. Even more. So this is coming from Krishna. Śrīmatī Radhika, she is Kamakeli Kovira. She is expert in this Kamakeli, these loving affairs, and therefore she manifests this mood. Always when Krishna is coming, oh, don't touch me, go away. Śrīla Gurudeva has revealed his heart in this, you know, sublime painting of our god sister Shalvani Didi. Now, Krishna is there begging Radhika, and I'm not interested. When Krishna is even more eager, he surrenders everything, he speaks of his fruit, everything. What else do you want? I'll give my fruit to you. What else, please? No, but she's pretending no interest. But when Gauranga Mahaprabhu manifests, Krishna manifests with the mood of Radhika. No, she also wants to assist him. But not in the same mood, not opposed, not she has become submissive. Because whereas gopis told Krishna, thanks, no, you're not the girl. Śrīmatī Radhika, she was thinking, if only I could be a boy. So she cannot fully associate with Krishna. There's always some superior, some gurujan. No, even if she's looking from far, somebody will say, hey, don't look like that. You're a chess woman, you protect the tribe of the dynasty, don't you know where you're coming from? Even in the morning, when the parents want to wake up in the Shantarila, the first thing they tell her is, Radhe, it's already so late. What if any gurujan will find you here? What a shame for your family, get up. So she has always this apprehension, I cannot fully associate with my sham. If only I could be a boy, then the whole day I would be wandering, passing around with him. Instead of that, you know, he leaves in the morning, I'm locked up, you know, half of the day in Java, desperately looking for some excuse to get out. Finally, she manages to meet him a couple hours in the afternoon. Then again, he comes back to the, you know, village, and again, separation, delays and everything. So she's dreaming, oh, if only I could be a boy. Is there any desire of hers which would not be satisfied? Not possible. Therefore she comes as Gadadhara Pandit. Now she's in male body. And her sham is in male body also, as Gaurasundar. And now they can freely, you know, associate. So from very birth, from very small, Gadara Pandit, he associates with Govardhan as school friends, growing together. Then when he heard that Mahaprabhu would attend sannyas, oh, now what to do? I have to go also and take sannyas and live with him. So he also took sannyas and went to Puri and associated with Mahaprabhu. And he was coming now in a very submissive mood. Shrashila Maharaj said, like Rukmini, in that kind of mood, not opposed, very submissive, trying to help him fulfill his desire. Now his desire is to understand Srimati Radhika's position. He is a Vishaya of love, the object of love. Now he wants to experience what is the position of the Ashraya of love, the beloved. And therefore he has to take her position. But he doesn't really know how to do it. So she is coming from Gadara Pandit and she is teaching him. But you know, the movements of love, they are very crooked. Like the movement of a snake. It's very crooked of love. It's very zigzag way. So he's not telling him, oh, I am Radhika, you are Krishna Chandra, and if you want to understand my mood, therefore I will tell you. No. He will say, oh, what about having a Bhagavatam class? And under the pretext of the class, then during the class he will speak on Leela from the point of view of Radhika. When you hear Bhagavatam, you read the Bhagavatam, it's over from the point of view of Krishna himself. But now, Radhika in the form of Bhagavatam, he said, insisted that this is what I was feeling. What I was experiencing, because this is exactly what he wants to know. Then he wants to go to Vrindavan. Why go to Vrindavan? Because now he has come in this world like in a laboratory. No? Science laboratory to experience the science of Premaras. This is the subject now he's studying, Premaras. He wants to get his degree. No, he wants to get his PhD in Premaras science. Which better laboratory than Vrindavan? Therefore he wants to come to Vrindavan because this is the place where Radha and Krishna are their leaders. In Puri, he's only hearing about it, but that desire is in him. Okay, I want to go in the laboratory and practice there. He has gone to South India after taking Diksha. Diksha is not sufficient. Also, Siksha is needed. Going down to South India and hearing Siksha from Ramananda. Then coming back to Puri and practicing in Gambira. But not enough. I have to go to the special room in laboratory, special experience room. And he's coming to Vrindavan to try to experience this here in this very place. And here everything is reminding him of the moods of Krishna and Radhika. Every tree, every creeper, everything is saturated with those moods. Srila Gurudev would say sometimes, when you speak of the Sikhs with Swami, we said that they were very renounced and sleeping every evening under a different tree. Some people say, oh, because they were so renounced, not to get attached. Gurudev said, this is very external reason. No. It was not for that reason. They knew every one of those trees has been witnessing so many amazing pastimes. And if I sleep under this tree, now I'm praying to that tree, maybe by his mercy, some of this lila will come in my heart. Just like we hear during this Varikama. This is what we're supposed to do. Every lila study, every place we're going, every holy kun, every holy tree, temple, deity, we bow down our head with a tilak mark, which is expressing our aspiration. I want to serve Radha and Krishna in Vrindavan. And Anna Vilashita Shunyam without any other desire. We do this every morning when we do our tilak. Radha, Krishna in Vrindavan. This is my aspiration. That when you buy something in the shop, there is this code behind, bar. And then we go in front of the change and we call the price. So this is transcendental code bar on our forehead. When we go in front of the deity, Cocoon, the holy tree, the Lila Sali, who said, please recover my aspirations. Like that. This is stamp. We are stamp. Yes. We are aspiring to be dust, dust and dust. We are slaves. We are offering our heads as slaves. Shashira Maharaj says, dust means slave. You cannot enter that throne unless you become the slave of the slave. So all my message, slave, I'm not a slave. Don't you know who I am? I am such an important person. Bow down, bow down. But he says, to be the slave of such a person, which person? That Param Brahma Krishna. At which speak all the gods are bowing down. Brahma, coming from Brahma, Shiva, everyone. They're bowing down to him. So to become the slave of such a person, such a high position it is. Don't think it is insignificant. I'm just a servant. This just is too much. Yes, the servant of that Supreme Lord, the slave of that Supreme Lord, such a high position. Such a high position. Don't think it is a little thing. So we get that stamp. And we aspire to that when we go in Parikrama. Please let those moons come in my heart. That was something we're doing this. So Mahaprabhu, when he came here, from every tree, every kun, he was getting this inspiration, those moons. Now, if you read Chaitanya Charitamrita, it is not described exactly which moons were there. Now, we just heard from the Lotus Mahaprabhu or Tirtha Maharaj, oh, so many kind of Nayikas. 15 kinds, multiplied by 361. But 8 main ones. Now, which moon Mahaprabhu experienced here? Chaitanya Charitamrita doesn't say. Well, was he in the mood of Svadhina Dhatrika? He is doubtful, because that means when Radhika is meeting with Krishna. No, she's telling him, oh, no, you worship the deity of Prem? No, you should, rearrange. Oh, you messed up my hair. Please do my hair again. Oh, look, all my decoration and all. You do again. Oh, you brought this necklace. Do again. And very happily he's doing. What's my problem? Testing that mood, it is quite doubtful. Because his whole bhajan is in Prarambha path. It's in the mood of separation. In the word of Srila Gauravin Maharaj, the beloved Shaguru, Krishna, Lila is a big river, very strong dhara current. And river has two banks. Vrindavan or Krishna Lila is a bank of union. Although the main mood of gopis and Radhika is separation, still union is predominant. But Gora Lila, the other bank, it is called the bank of separation. Separation mood is predominant. And this is the bhajan that we are supposed to do. Worshipping with the mood of separation from Krishna. This is what Mahaprabhu was doing. He was not in the mood of meeting. He was aspiring to meet, but deeply, bitterly lamenting. And when he was in Vrindavan, everything was reminding him so much of Krishna. Everything. Seeing the Yamuna, all his pastimes were coming in his mind. Everything. So much so that after some time, he was thinking, oh, if I remain here, my mood as Krishna will come out. I should go. And externally he inspired his assistant, to take him away. Because when he came once to Akurgat, and he saw the Jamuna, some mood came in his heart. Oh, this is the place where Akura saw Vaikuntha, but the Gopas, they saw Goloka. So he jumped in Jamuna and stayed under for a long time. And Bhagavatam was saying, oh my God. So he pulled him out and he was thinking, what if he goes, if he does this in Vrindavan when I'm not with him? If he goes in Jamuna and drowns, we should take it away. Although when Mahaprabhu came, not only had the mood but also the color of Radhika. Why also the color? Because he's crying for Krishna, but suddenly he looks at his hand and he's black like Krishna. How he can be crying for Krishna? Oh, I am Krishna, what I am crying for? So he has to have also not only the mood, but the color of Radhika. another reason that one time she wanted, she expressed a desire, she wanted to embrace him from top to bottom, every part of his body. Because she's saying every atom of my body is aching to be united with every atom of his body. That is not possible even in a tight embrace. Therefore, when he took her cover, then she could cover him and embrace him from top to bottom. Another reason. So Mahaprabhu came here in Vrindavan and he showed us what we should do Vrindavan Parikrama. Going to every place and absorb ourselves in remembrance of the leaders. Because we cannot remember what we have not seen. Srila Gaudiya Majestu said, to hear is to see. He used to speak of Shuddha Ikshuddha Pantha, the path of seeing with the ears. No. How does it work? Oh, Gurudev is speaking some Lila Katha, and the heart of the disciple has become very clean after so many, many years, or maybe lifetime, I don't know, of practice. And whatever Guru is speaking, that Lila is impressed in the heart. When disciple is taking his mantra and chanting, that Lila manifests in his heart, that is called Smaran, Lila Smaran. But Srila Prabhupada used to say, what can you remember you have not seen? Have you seen? No, then you have not heard. Living is to see. If you have not seen, it means you have not really heard. Your heart is still filled of so many anathas, and what you cannot hear it, it is not entering into your heart. So, what to do? This is plan A. There is always plan B. Intelligent person shall plan B, alternative, right? So the alternative is the hearing of Sila from the lotus mouths of the Vaishnavas who have been treading these pathway of Vrindavan for so many years with Gurudev, and they have heard from the lotus mouths of Gurudev and Vaishnavas all the leelas, not pertaining to each place. So whenever we go in Parikram, we stop and we hear from Shukartita Maharaj or Rasamda Prabhu or the Vaishnavas what they have heard, they are speaking. Therefore, we go in the Leela study. And we follow the footsteps of Mahaprabhu, giving in every place the glories of that place. Then we are begging the dust of the Kund of the holy trees, please let some of that Lila come in my heart. And if some of that can come in your heart, then all Parikrama is successful. That is why we have come to Vrindavan. That is why Gurudev was saying, I know that in the West you are living in Swarga. So I'm telling you, my dear demigods, you give up this Swarga Loka for some time, you come to India with me, at least 1 month a year, do some tapasya, you know, away from your beautiful wives and beautiful mansions and palaces and openness. Come and live a simple life with me in Vrindavan, and we go from place to place and then train that those lilas and moods come in our heart. That is Gurudev's transcendental trick to bring us here and to give us a chance in the association of Vaishnavas to go to every place where all the acharyas, beginning with the supreme acharya Mahaprabhu himself, Krishna himself in the form of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, all those places he has come. That what he has done, we are following. This is why we are Gaudiya Vaishnavas. Death is the desire to enjoy the body of the opposite sex. That is death. And what is disease? Disease is envy and illusion that agitate internally and externally ourselves. That is disease. What is heaven? Heaven is to have the association of those devotees who have love for Maharaj and his son. And what is the purport, the confidential purport of the Upanishad? That is speaking to God and the beloved divine father, God of the Shri. He says that if a person doesn't want to work very hard to obtain his goal, he should come to Shri Vrindavan. There's so many difficult sadhanas and practices, austerities, renunciation. But this is not necessary in Vrindavan. The land of Vrindavan itself is emanating like the sun, the moon, and fire, extreme effulgence. What is that effulgence? That is love for Sri Radha and Krishna. So just being here, without doing anything, just eating and sleeping, existing here, one receives so much benefit because this land is emanating transcendental vibrations of love for Radha and Krishna. Every tree, every creeper, every animal, every living being has a function to support the divine good, especially the amorous pastimes of Radha and Krishna. So Vrindavan is such a Mathurya mind, very sweet pastime place. When Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came here, as Sri Kuchipada, Sri Advaita Maharaj said, he didn't stay. He stayed in Puri, he stayed in Namdweep, he only came a very short time to Vrindavan. Even though he is the combined form of Radha and Krishna, his mood was different. And if he stayed here in Vrindavan, he would be reminded, because everything is Udipana. All the, even though Vrindavan is not manifest, like with all the temples and the kirtans and everything like today, still, Mahaprabhu could see the pastime places, and he would remember that he's Krishna. He wanted to forget he's Krishna. He wanted to take the mood and the mentality and the devotional sentiment of Srimati Radha. So just like we don't put a peacock feather on the head of Gauranga because that will disturb his mood. It will remind him that he's Krishna. He wants to think he's Radha, searching for Krishna. So this time of year, coming to Vrindavan, the Sard season, the fall, autumn season is very special. The hot summer season has evaporated all the water from the lakes and rivers, and the rainy season carrying, pouring down the clouds and beautifying the land. The grass and the creepers, everything was growing, became lush, the rivers and lakes became full. Now, after so many months, everyone was staying inside. Krishna, Balaram, the gopis, everyone was confined to their houses. But when the autumn season came in this month, then Krishna Balaram took the cows out to graze them. And on that pretext, they could meet. Sri Krishna could meet Radharani at Radhapur and all their pastime places. So this fall autumn season is very auspicious. There's so many different pastimes occur during this time. And also, so many of our great Gaudiya Acharyas have either appeared or disappeared.
श्री भक्ति प्रज्ञान के ईश्वर महाराज आप हम सभी हैं By disappearing out of his heart for me, he manifested that he was entering into Rasa. So many sweet paths have been going on. Parampurishapad, Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj, Vishnu Maharaj also disappeared from the world during this time. So this month of the autumn month, Kartik Prat, Purim Prat, is a very special time. Rasalila is going on in the bank of the Jumuna. Bhakti Vinod Thakur has sung.
Hare Krishna. We have been hearing about the glories of Sri Bhagavan. And in Bhagavad-gita also, Sahib Rahmani says, Vanadeva Moksha Namoksha Vadeva. I don't know what you are going to do. So somebody asked a gopi, we want to go to Vaikuntha. Then what she answered that we could say, this is in Hindi. So please, excuse me, I can't translate it in Hindi.
Radharani herself. So,